Now let's look at some data types that we'll be using in the course. So there's a few that we'll be using pretty frequently, and then some that we'll be using later on near the end. So I'll just talk about the ones we're going to use in the beginning. So you might see in the book something that looks like this: declare name, declare string name, declare real x, declare integer y, and you probably won't see this one for a while, but declare boolean is valid. So what are these things? Well, a string is a piece of text, and we typically write them with delimiters. So for example, if I want to write a name, I can say name equal Mark Goodman. And this sets a new variable called name to the value Mark Goodman. In Python, you can either use double quotes to mark the end of the string, or you can use single quotes. Either way will work in Python. So print name. Print name. You'll notice when I print the name, it comes out without the double quotes around it. So the double quotes are not actually part of the string. Instead, they're just markers for where the string starts and ends. And you always have to pair them up. So if you have double quote to start a string, you always have to have a double quote at the end to close it off. And same with single quotes. If you're going to start a string with a single quote, you need to have a single quote that matches it. So those are strings. Reals are numbers, or decimal numbers. So what we mean by decimal is like x is equal to 3.0. This point here is a decimal point, and any number that has a decimal point in it is a decimal number. So reals are decimal numbers. They're also called floating point numbers in Python. So x equals 3.0, or x equals 3.1415, or x equals 24.0, or x is equal to 0.3. Just like I can print strings, I can also print numbers. So if I run this program, you'll see I get 3.0, 3.1415, and so on. Now, the pseudocode for this is going to look something like declare real x, set x equal 3.0, display x, set x equal 3.1415, display x, set x equal 2456.0, display x, and finally set x equals 0.3, display x. So this piece of pseudocode matches this piece of Python code. Now there's one difference that's kind of important. So you'll notice that in my pseudocode, I have to declare the variable x as real before I can start using it. That's not required in Python because variables are automatically created whenever you assign to them. So anytime I set the value of a variable, that creates the variable if it doesn't exist already. Now, for consistency with our pseudocode though, anytime you have a declare statement, you should also write a corresponding Python statement. So this declare real x, it creates a variable named x that holds decimal values. X equals 0 creates a new variable named x, and we're going to assign its initial value to be a default, 0.0 for decimals, double quote for strings, and so on. So if we look at our strings up here, where it says declare string name, the way we're going to do that is by setting name equal to double quote. And the way that we declare the real x is x equal 0.0. The way we declare an integer, which is a whole number, is we say y equals 0. So that's a whole number. And then Boolean is either going to be true or false. So we'll set is valid equal false. So these four declare statements match these four variable declarations. Now let's look at integers. So if we had pseudocode like we would translate it into Python as x equals 0, y equals 0, and then I like to leave a blank line between my declarations and my actual code. Then we set x equal to 1 and set y equal to 2. And finally, we display the value of x and y. So let's get rid of all of this code and run our program. Okay. So that's everything for variable types and declarations. In the next video, we'll look at calculation.